everybody. It is Patsy, or good afternoon, early afternoon. It's Patsy from Patsy's Crochet. I'm here with a tutorial on my beanie. You can, this is a size 4 weight, medium size 4 weight. I believe this is the yarn that I had given to me from Cynthia Venture. I believe she said this is soft and sleek. From Hobby Lobby, so this is beautiful yarn to work with, and it is. This would keep a child's head warm. Okay, and then I made it a little bit bigger for a bigger toddler or child, as you can see. So this is the one that we're going to be working with today. So I'll show you how to do this. Now I'm hoping that my light doesn't go off and on all the time. I'm not understanding why it does this. I always seem to have problems with the light. Okay, so let's move this out of the way and we'll start. So today we're going to use Canadiana. It's royal blue. It's a medium number 4, and it says use a 4.5 millimeter knit needle or a 5 millimeter crochet hook. So we are going to try it with this color today. So I'm hoping that this will turn out pretty nice. And we're also using a 5 millimeter crochet hook from Hover that I got from my good friend Cynthia Venture. Get prepared, but I like to start from the middle, and the yarn is coming out from the other side, so let's just see where we're going to get this blob of yarn from. So I hope everybody in the United States is having a happy Thanksgiving. Oh yeah, it came out in a lump. Of course, why wouldn't it, right? So I'm doing this, which is a little talk. Sorry about that. So I hope everybody's having a happy Thanksgiving and enjoying your day with your friends and your family. And just be safe, you know, driving. The weather out here is not bad here in Fort Erie, Ontario. It's, the snow is melting. Which everybody likes that, but I like the cooler. I like the snow. I like Christmas. I like the snow on the ground. Okay, this is getting... At least I got a lot of yarn out, so I don't have to worry about pulling it. This is a very nice blue. And once my hands stop, it'll be okay. So I hope this tutorial turns out good for you. Now, the one I'm going to do for you today will be for an older child, but remember, you can use any yarn, but I use a size 4 yarn for a nice toque or a hat. I usually use a 4.5 millimeter crochet hook, but today I'm using a size 5 for the tutorial. Okay. You can do these for adults, childs, or babies. It all depends how many you put in your ring. Okay, so I'm going to do the magic ring. I have a hard time sometimes doing the hard magic ring, but, or the magic ring, but we'll get it. So, so this is how I do mine. Now what we're going to do is place 8 half double crochets into the center ring. Now this is for a child. If you want it more, you can add 10, or you can do 12. It all depends the size of hook and what size of yarn you're using. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now I did not count the chain, so I did 8. See how small that gets? Really cute little fat. And then I just go into here and do my first slip stitch. And then I chain up 2. Okay, now what we're going to do is do 2 half double crochets each stitch. So remember, this does not include that. So we're going to do 1 and 2 half double crochets in that stitch. So all the way around each stitch is 2. 2 in the next. Now half double crochets are very easy. Yarn over, go through, pull your yarn through. You have 3 chains on your hook. And pull through all 3. And that is 2 that one. So we do it again. Yarn over, pull through. You have 3. Yarn over, pull through 3. Yarn over, go through, pull through. Yarn over, go through 3. So we're going to do 2 in each chain, okay? So 2, 4, 6. You can add another color after we start. I'd like to add in a different color, which I will probably add some white or something. I'll make this for a boy or a girl. Okay, that's our, I call it a dummy stitch. But I just go through the first double crochet, which that's your chain, and you're just going to go right through, and so that's the start of your painting. Now, I hope this ain't too dark, and then you're going to chain 2, and you're going to add another half double crochet to that one, another half double crochet. So now we're going to 2 half double crochets, go to your next stitch, and you're going to do 1 half double crochet. The next one, you're going to do 2 half double crochets, finish 2, next one is 1, next one is 2, next one is 1, next one is 2. Next one. Would be nice to see. I don't know if it's me or the lady. Okay. And this is 2. And this one. This one is 1. Next one is 2. Next one is 1. Next one is 2. I'm just going to repeat that all the way to the end. I'm not supposed to let it out too, but that's okay. I'm going to just put the one in there. Okay? And then we'll grab that chain. And then we'll go. That's what it looks like starting. So that's your, let's see, 2. So now we're on row 3, I believe. And we're crochet 2 times in your first chain. Then you're going to do 1 half double crochet, and the next stitch you're going to do another half double crochet. So now you got 2 half double crochets here, 1 half double crochet in the next one, half double crochet in the next one, and now you're doing 2 into the third. Next stitch you're doing 1, next stitch you're doing 2, next stitch you're doing, oops, sorry, is 2 half double crochets. Okay, see, so you got 2, 1, 1, 2. So 1, 1, and 2. You guys can hear me, and 2 into that one, and then 1, 1, and 2, and 1, and 1, and 2, and 1, and 1, and 2. And then 1. Chain 2. Chain 2 again. Then, now we're on to the third one. Third row. Let me see. 1, 2. That is 2. Now we're doing 3. So, 1 and 2 half double crochets in the same stitch as where the two chains are. And then we're going to do 1 half double crochet. 2 half double crochets, 3 half double crochets. Okay, so you got 2 half double crochets at the beginning, 1 half double crochet in the next stitch, half double crochet in the next, half double crochet in the next, and now you're going to do the fourth stitch, you're going to do 2 half double crochets. And then you're going back to 1. So we got double, 1, 2, 3, and then the fourth chain you do two half doubles, and then you're doing a half double on the next, a half double onto the next, a half double onto the next. So that will make 3 half doubles, and then you're going to do 2 half doubles in the same stitch. Then you do 1 half double in the next, half double into the next, half double into the next. And then you do 2 half doubles in the fourth. 1 half double, 2 half doubles, 3 half doubles, and 4 half doubles going in. So you do 2 in that one. So you do 1 again, another one, and the third one, and then the fourth one you do 2 half doubles. Two half doubles. I hope I'm not going too fast for you. I hope that you can see what I'm doing. And then I'm going to do 1 half double, 2 half doubles, and last one is 3 half doubles. Then you go slip stitch into the top of that chain, and there you go. So, it's for a newborn, you switch right here, but we're going to do one more round. So we're going to chain 2. And we're going to do 2 half doubles into the chain. Okay. And then we're going to do 1 half double, 2 half doubles, 3 half doubles, 4 half doubles, and 2 in the fifth. There's the fourth. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we did 1, 2, 3 down there. So yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 2 in the fifth. And then we do 1 half double in the next one. Half double into the next. Half double into the next. Half double into the next. And half double. 2 half doubles into the fifth. Okay. And then we do 1 half double. A half double into the next, half double into the next. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4 half doubles, and then we do the fifth one, we do 2 half doubles. Okay, 1 half double, next 1 half double, next 1 half double, and next 1 half double, and into the fifth one, we do 2 half doubles. And just keep going around until we have it to round. So if you have to stop and count, that's okay. 3, and that is 4. And then the fifth one, we do 2 half doubles. And then we do 1 half double in the next, half double in the next, half double in the next. So that would be 3 half doubles. Fifth one, we do 2 half doubles, 1 and 2. And then the next, we do 1 half double. Oh, I hope you guys can see this. 2 half doubles. We'll do 1 half double, 2 half doubles, 3 half doubles, and 4. And then we'll do 6 stitches right into the first chain, and there. That's how we got our circle. Now, what I do now, like you can keep going until you get to the size that you want it for, okay? So the next one you would do 2 half doubles in the beginning, and then you do 5 half doubles, like a half double each stitch for 5, and then the sixth one you do 2 half doubles, but I'm stopping here for a child's hat. Now what I'm going to do is just chain up 2, and then I'm going to not increase, so I'm not going to put one in here. I go to the next stitch and I do a half double. So I'm going to do a half double, 1 half double in each around. Easy as that. Sorry. It's a very easy hat. Only takes me about an hour to do that. Sometimes it's not even an hour. It all depends what size I'm doing. I don't know how many I could do. If I'm watching a good show, I could do more. See, I usually use the size 4.5 crochet hook. That's okay. This one's going to be a little bit bigger for baby child. Adult or toddler. Okay, let's stitch into that one. Yeah. Okay, see how it's starting to grow. tune to. And now, what we're going to do, as is, guys, I know the lighting thing. I'm going to do one more round, I think, of that, so we can start going down. So we don't do the first, we go to the next and do that half double. So do two rounds of just one single half double, sorry, one half double in each stitch around. How you can create your own. You just whatever. I'm thinking about doing, like I said, leg warmers. I want it to match the hats for a little child, like for a little child, for a girl, and for a woman. I don't think maybe about leg warmers or boot cuffs, which I've never seen before, but you never know. Let me grab one. There we go. Let's keep going. So, so might do a different color. Guys, and my directions and instructions are helping for beginners or anybody that's out there that wants to learn. I know it's been a while since I've been here doing a tutorial. As long as you know I'm still here. Okay, we are almost done this last part of this row. And it's first and slip stitch. See, now it's starting to curl under. See? And that's what we want. So, what we're going to do is cut, because I want to put another color in with this. Just give me a second. I have to get my little scissors. Also use stitch markers for the beginners. I usually use stitch marks when I do ponchos, sweaters. Okay, so I just leave enough like that. So now what we're going to do is put another color in it. I was wondering if we should put a white. Let me see what that looks like against the camera. Nah. We'll put a lighter blue in. Yeah. Okay. Yes, we do. Oh, yes, we do. I'm going to get out the navy blue side. Okay, so I hope that you're catching up. I don't know if I did it too fast. I hope I did it. But we could just talk for a few seconds while I get this organized. It won't take long. Colors. And these are both Canadianas. Paint the Canadiana. Super soft yarn. And it stretches too when you're making it. So that's why I usually go down a hook size or a half a hook size when I use this. But like I said, today for the tutorial, I'm just doing a size 5 hook. Okay. So, how I add mine, I'll show you. I just make sure that is tight, okay? just add in the blue, the light blue. Okay, like that. And I put that down. And then we start. So I chain up two. Now we're going to do front loop and back loop, half double crochet. So we're going to yarn over, go into your first stitch there, go to the front, go through, pull your yarn, grab your yarn, or hook yarn, sorry. You have three on your hook, and you're just going right through, just like what we just did, but you're doing that front post, back post. Don't worry about tails, we'll hide them in after. And then for the back loop, you're going, you're taking your yarn, you're going to go through and through of that stitch. Then you're going to pull it back. And then you're going to yarn over and pull through all three. And that is it. That's all you're doing. So back post is grab your yarn, go through the back, around the front to the back, pull it through, yarn over, go through all three. Front post is yarn over, go to the front, grab your yarn, pull it through, and yarn over, go through all three. Back and front. Back and front. Back and front. It's very easy to do. Take your time and you'll be able to get it for all the beginners out there. Okay, so yarn for front post again, yarn over your hook, go to the front, like that. Yarn over and pull through, yarn over, go through all three. Back loop is going to the back, around the front like that, and to the back. Pull it through, and there you go. So these are all half double crochet, front post and back post. You can add as many colors as you want into this, into your project. But try to use the same yarn, but different colors.
Turn down my cell.
Okay, there, I shut off my cell, thank you. And now back post, front post, back post, front post. Remember, these are all half double crochets. I get faster after a while. It does get fast after a while. I'm sorry. I'm trying my best to keep it. You guys can see what I'm doing. Now, I usually do, for childs, I usually do four rounds of the front post, back post. Okay. So this will be row number one, and we're almost done. And then, see right here what we do, just go, you do your last back post, yarn over, and it's a slip stitch, and you pull it together. Chain two. Now we're just going to repeat it, repeat this four times. I hope you guys can see. I don't know what's going on with this lighting. I'm using, there's light outside too that's coming in, so front posting. Oh, sorry. Front post. And then back post. And front post. Back post. half double. Okay, I'll pause the video and I'll let you guys do it. I'll meet you back up at the end of the fourth row. Fourth round, sorry. Okay, I'm back and I'm almost at my end of my fourth round. Change yarns yet, but what we're going to do is half double crochets all the way around. We're going to do two rows of half double crochets of this light blue. So all you're doing is half double crochets all the way around. Very easy. We do two rows of the half double crochets all the way around each stitch. It's a very easy pattern. I just did it in a half hour talking to the girls online, and that was it. So I thought I'd do a tutorial. The girls wanted a tutorial done, so I'm doing one for you guys. I just hope that you guys can see what I'm doing, because I really would love to see some projects. You know, I do have a Facebook page. You can also email me. My email address is in the description box. Take a picture. Let me know if you like the pattern or you don't like it. Or sorry, the tutorial. You can show me pictures. If you're on Facebook, just go to my crochet site there and post pictures of the makes. It doesn't matter if it's not my tutorial or if you have different, you know, just post it. I'd love to see what you guys are working on. And then we're going to just slip stitch into the top of that. See? So what we're going to do is just create a little gap. And then we add the darker blue back. But see, it's totally up to you if you want to do two colors. You can do three colors. You can do, you know, I like doing two colors, sometimes three. I like using the variegated, but if I don't have variegated, I just do it like this. You can have solids. So remember, we're just doing two rounds of the half double crochet stitch with this light blue. And then we're going to change it back over to the dark royal blue. Not dark blue, but royal. And that's it. Now, so it's such an easy. I just hope I'm not going too fast for you. And hopefully you guys can see the video. Make this as big as you want. Remember that. This all depends on your in there. I usually do a 6 to 8 for a child. Older I do 10 to 12. Sometimes I do 15. It all depends on your hook and your besides you. If you want. Needle here. Skip that long enough so we can sew it in and after. So we'll get the dark blue again. Here, my little friend. There. Okay, and then what we'll do is add the royal blue back in. So you just pull it tight like that. Leave a long enough tail to sew in. Some people just crochet in the tails, but I like sewing in too because that way you know it's in and it's not going to fall out. So then you just want to chain two, make sure that light blue's down, and then you're going to do one row of half double crochet. So what I do, I usually do, do one tie around. So, oops. So I half double crochet stitch again. But what I'm going to do is put my tails in just once. Okay, that way they're in. We're going to do one half double crochet round of the navy blue, or the royal blue, sorry. So then that way it's all even looking. And then we just start that half double front post, half double again. Like you can end it here, it all depends how small your baby's child's head is. Do the front post, back post. Now if you don't want to do four to make it even, you can do, this is four, you can do just three and then end off with the light blue for the half double crochet rows or the single, all depends. This color is clear water. So this lighter blue is called clear water. That's nice. It's very soft yarn. This Peyton's Canadian. Into that first one. Okay, chain up two. See, that looks not pretty. That looks pretty. I liked it. Okay. So now what we're going to do is the front post, half double, back, half double, front post, and back post. Okay. So in your first stitch, you're going to yarn over, go through your front post, go through, yarn over, go through your back post, go through, yarn over, go through all. half double crochet from post and back. Front post is like that. So that's your front post. Yarn over, go through. Yarn over, pull through. Now back post, you grab your yarn, hook it, hold it, go around the back of the post. Pull through. Yarn over, there you go. Front post, same. Back post. So what I usually do is do 4 rounds. But for this tutorial, I think I'm just going to do 4 rows of the half double front post back post. Might as well keep this. Some kids have light slots by their ears, and this will definitely keep them warm because it's the way that we're doing it. So, I'm just going to continue on for 4 rows. So this is your first row of half double front post, back post. Okay, but what I'll do is I'll meet you back almost at the end of the 4th one. Okay, we're almost done. Our last row of the front post, back post, half double crochet. Slip stitch. Now, either you could change your yarn from the royal blue back into here and do your last single crochets, or you could do half double crochets down here. Is that cute? I like that. Okay, so what I'm just going to keep it as the royal blue. So I'm just going to chain up 2 and then do a half double crochet all the way around each stitch. I usually do 2 rows. Like, you can do as many rows as you want of the half double crochet. Okay? You can do as many rows of the half double crochet front post, back post, too. It's entirely up to you. I'll just show you how I made this. And I think you guys will really enjoy it. I just hope that you guys, the video turned out good for you to see what I'm doing. Give me a second, please. Sorry about that. I had an important phone call. Okay, so like I said, we're going to do 2 rows of the half double crochets. So we're almost done the first row. I'm sorry the video is long, but it's good to show people what you're talking about and how to do it. And I hope that I explained it well. and that you guys can see what I am actually doing. I'm trying to pick yarns that my video will pick up in my camera. And if you don't want to do, you know, two rows of the half double crochet, you can do whatever you like. You can, honestly. But I like the two, because two makes it a little bit longer to stretch over the baby. And then you make sure the ears are warmer, so we'll just do one more. Oops. Half double crochets around. And then that's it. And you sew in your ends, and you can start your next one, make a bigger one for a bigger child. It all depends. But I just wanted to show you how easy it was for me to come up with this. I was just sitting there fiddling around, and that's what it came up. I like the style. Sorry. I was just doing the half double crochets. And now a slip stitch, and that is it. Now what I do is I double knot that. Double chain it. And then I cut it long enough. Pull my yarn. And what I do is pull down these two. Oops, I did. And look. So you can put a pom-pom up top. There's that. Now you just have to stitch in your stitchery. And voila. Done. And the back does not look bad. And the front doesn't look bad. That looks good. And it's nice and warm around here. And here. And the ears. It's nice and warm. Okay. So I hope that you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and I'll be back shortly with another tutorial. God bless you all, and have a great, safe holiday. Bye for now.